Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and Graham Swindells is joining us today from Deltic Energy. A warm welcome to you, because you've been able to confirm this week the commitment from Shell to drill Deltic's Selene gas prospect. A positive development for Deltic then, Graham?
Absolutely, Katie. We're absolutely delighted to have been able to announce this latest development and the commitment from Shell to drill the Selene prospect. I think importantly, this commitment has also been made to the NSTA, our regulator, which now means that Selene is very much a firm well commitment and will definitely be drilled. Yeah, absolutely. So great news for Deltic, and represents a very significant milestone for us in the development of a company.
Okay, you describe it as a significant milestone. So let's maybe pick up on why this is so important. Why is this commitment to drill the Selene prospect so important for Deltic, would you say?
That's right. It really is very, very important to us, and a very significant development. And that's really for a number of reasons. I think, first of all, it really demonstrates the quality of the asset. It serves as an endorsement of the company, our business model, the quality of the assets and the partnerships that we have. I think very importantly for us, and just following on from the recent commitment from Shell to drill our Pensacola prospect, just adding that additional well to the drilling program really significantly enhances and de-risks the investment proposition for Deltic, and that's critically important as well. I think what it also does is it reinforces Shell's commitment to our partnership and to the North Sea and exploration as a whole. I think it's very good for the UK, for the North Sea, the exploration industry, particularly at a time when the ongoing requirement for domestic production remains critically important, and at a time when energy security is as important as ever. And we're certainly seeing something of a rejuvenation of the Southern North Sea, and we're very pleased and proud to be playing a key role in that rejuvenation.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to talk about that a little bit later on, but for now, let's just concentrate on the Selene gas prospect itself. What more can you tell us about it, and why it's such an exciting prospect as you describe it?
Yeah, I mean, Selene really is a fantastic, high impact, relatively low risk prospect. We estimate the prospect to contain 318 BCF of gas. It's situated in the Le Mans sandstone plate fairway in the southern North Sea, and it's one of the largest untested or unappraised structures in that area. And at 318 BCF, that's the equivalent of over 50 million barrels of oil, so a very significant prospect. Added to that, it's got relatively high chances of success, certainly for an exploration prospect, 70%. And what that means is that in many respects it's more akin to an appraisal well than an exploration well. We retain a very healthy equity position at 50%, which is great, and we're also carried for half of our costs, such that we're only paying 25% of the costs, certainly up to a cap of $25 million. So that's excellent in terms of cost mitigation. But also that very healthy equity position means that we have a great deal of flexibility from which to farm down further should it make economic sense to do so, and we decide to do so.
All right, and what are the next steps in progressing Selene?
So technical, commercial and economic assessment and appraisal are all complete. So we now move on to the next phase, which is primarily around well planning. And the various steps involved in that will be well design, well planning, rig procurement, and other work streams really to support the well planning and drilling operations. And while we're not yet in a position to have secured an exact rig slot for the drilling of this prospect, we would certainly expect to firm that up through the planning phase.
All right. Now, this is a topic you alluded to earlier. What impact have these tax reliefs, which have been introduced by the UK government as part of the Windfall Tax, the Energy Profits Levy, what have they had on you? And do you think that this will stimulate further investment in North Sea projects like Deltics from the likes of Shell and others?
Yeah. Well, that's a really good question, Katie. And I think, first of all, it's important to stress that certainly we're not in favour of the windfall tax or the energy profits levy, as it's now known. And I don't think it's particularly helpful, particularly for industry from the perspective of demonstrating fiscal stability. However, for companies like Deltic, there's no doubt that this has actually presented an opportunity for us, and that comes in the form of the investment allowance, which has been introduced as part of this to try and incentivize further investment in the North Sea and to promote energy security. And what that does is it introduces tax reliefs such that for companies or operators that are subject to the EPL, they effectively have up to a 91% cost saving for any new qualifying investments, which means that Deltic opportunities and assets, you know, such as Selene, Pensacola, and for that matter, any of our other opportunities and projects that we have within our portfolio, suddenly become even more economically and commercially attractive, and certainly will facilitate further investment into those prospects. So I certainly believe that while we're not necessarily supportive of the windfall tax, this certainly presents an opportunity for us. And I think the potential definitely exists there for us to see further investment into North Sea opportunities, such as the ones which sit within the Deltic portfolio.
All right, we'll leave it there. Graham, thank you very much indeed. Is there anything else that you want to add for us before we let you go?
No, I think I just want to sort of stress the, you know, how important development this is for us as a company and our shareholders. I think we have, it's a really exciting time for us as we move into the next operational phase of our development, particularly on the back of a recent confirmation of rig contract and the fact that we will very shortly be drilling, you know, our first well with Shell on the Pensacola prospect, which is another 300 BCF prospect in the southern North Sea. We're also continuing to work with our partner Capricorn on five licenses into which they've farmed into recently and have an extensive work program that's ongoing there. We're continuing with our 100% owned Central North Sea prospects, still running a farm out process on Dure, and very shortly going to be launching a farm out process on our Syros prospect. And of course, looking further ahead, we were very encouraged to see as part of the UK government's energy security strategy confirmation that there will be a further licensing round launched this year. And that's been a key component of our success in the past. We'll certainly be looking to or seek to replicate the success that we've had in previous licensing rounds there, and already looking at the opportunities we want to go after, both ourselves and in collaboration with other potential partners. So I think an awful lot to look forward to, both in the short, medium, and long term for Deltic and our shareholders. Lots of activity and catalysts as we seek to grow the company and create value for shareholders.
All right, well, we'll look forward to catching up on each one of those catalysts with you, Graham. Thank you very much. Graham Swindells from Deltic Energy this morning here with us on Proactive.
Thanks, Katie.